Okay, hello everyone. I can't hear anything now. I'm gonna wake up. Come on, it's Friday, guys. Hello everyone. Today is a very special day. We're shifting gears completely. Engagement is getting better and better each day, each week. We're really excited about today. Deb Galloway is gonna speak, one of our VPs in the finance department. And we're kind of like tying financial well-being and the health side together and kind of synergizing it, because when you feel better financially, everything else seems to fall in place. Roland's gonna also speak about this. Roland is a fantastic person. He's also on the financial committee. And we have a special guest speaker today, which is Ola, who's gonna start it off. Michelle Alonzo, our dietitian, is going to talk today, and she's going to briefly discuss some more affordable ways to find healthy food. All right, I don't know the specifics because she surprised me with it, but we're going to start off today with Ola. All right, come on up here, you. Get over here. This is Ola, ladies and gentlemen.
Some of you might know, I used to work in California, and the company was bought by Humana, and I wasn't sure what I was going to do. And then I saw an opportunity in South Florida, and I thought, yeah, that looks interesting, maybe I'll check it out. So I came to meet with Deb Galloway, and I think it was not as by the time I got back to California, and within a week, it was sort of decided that I was going to come down here. Now, that was in August of 2021. So after like being here for like 2 weeks, I found out that my neck, that my back was paining me. So I didn't know what was wrong with me, was it the stress, what was going on. Then I went downstairs to the gym, and I saw Pete. They said, well, what's the problem with you? I said, well, I just don't feel in my back. I think maybe it's the stress of work. I don't know. Then he got on of me and said, maybe you need to stretch. And he spent like 5 minutes with me, and it felt different. So from that day on, I was a convert to whatever I was doing.
So it was love at first sight again. Started with Dad, finished with Dad.
So since then, I've been going to the gym, and part of the thing I did for myself, which maybe some of you might not consider so smart, was I wanted to lock myself in. So what I do is I pay
3 months in.
3 months in advance. It's kept me grounded and committed most of 2014. I've not been as good this year, but I can attest to the vast improvement in my health and well-being. The way the program is structured here is so much flexibility, there's so much support from the company. I wasn't spinning before I started spinning, and I was going like twice a week. And this is looking at me because she got so well at the spinning, she lost so much weight, she stopped up. That's how good the program is. What I do now is I don't go to the spin as much as I used to, but I go at lunch by myself. And it's so good to have a structure and a company where lunch time is for 30 minutes, we can get in there, get on the spinning thing, do it for 20 minutes. So I feel different. So what I'm going to say, I'm not so well at ad-libbing this, is one, this is a great place to work. There's so much support from this market to make things work. Pete is doing all his best, and all I can do is encourage everybody to just make use of this opportunity. Thank you.
gentlemen, Deb Galloway.
Hello, how's everybody? I'm glad. The one thing is now I get to use with him the mic and he has a cold.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You didn't tell me that either.
So now I'm going to feel the love all over. So what we wanted to talk today about is financial fitness, because really, to have a whole rounded well-being, you need to have all your pieces in tow. And so a piece of it is your physical. I think there's like four tabs from a human standpoint. And one of those pillars that they talk about is security. And then security is your financial well-being and your self-support. I mean, there's a whole bunch of encompassing things, because if you don't have one side, it's hard to do the other. So it's trying to keep a balance with all the pieces. And really, and some of that is just peace of mind, because again, if you know what you're doing, how you're doing it, you have a plan, you have a process, it's actually less stressful. Excuse me? I hear something in the background. If everybody can make sure you mute your phone, I'd appreciate it. Thank you. And so part of having a financial well-being is actually not having the stress. Because even if you have debt, even if you have issues, if you don't know where your money is coming from, at least if you think about it and you have some foresight and some planning, it gives you a better peace of mind. And the other thing is your lifestyle. If you can plan and determine what you want to spend your money on, do you want to have another job? How are you going to get your finances in place? So a piece of it is, if you can do a little bit of forefront planning and processing, you actually can change your lifestyle. Do you want to go on a trip? Do you want to have a nice vacation? Well, how are you going to do that? Setting up those processes up front will all help you down the road. And then security. Really, part of that process is, again, if I can set up a financial plan, I'm going to be secure in the future. Or if I lose my job today, will I have enough money to support me for a month or two until I get another job or some other financial process? It's really having that sense of security and well-being, having less stress, making sure that you're planning during that process. Yeah. And it goes back to a couple different things. Okay, what do I want to do today? You know, how am I going to spend? What am I going to put my money on? What am I going to save for? But then you also need to know about tomorrow and then eventually in the future. Do I want to have something left for my children? Do I want to have a charitable donation in the past? Again, there's three pillars to it. It's how, just because I get a paycheck and it comes into my bank account, am I going to spend it all today? Am I going to leave some for tomorrow? Am I going to have some for the future? So you have to have that planning foresight that's going through that process pretty much on a daily basis. Finance can really be a huge stressor. And so what they saw is when there's a recession, divorce rates go up the roof. And a big part of relationships is understanding what your finances are. And it's kind of like something no one wants to talk about, but really, it's a big piece of our life. So if we don't have a good financial plan, we don't communicate that with our friends and family and the people around us, then we're going to have issues. And so that's part of the downside of not having a financial plan. There's tons of different things and resources and sites that you can go to help you create a financial plan for yourself. And one of them is, I'm a CPA, so the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants actually set up this charity, and they created this website called Feed the Pig. And it's this huge piggy bank, and you can kind of see things putting in little dollars into it. But it goes through the how-tos of what you want to do from a financial standpoint. There's pieces on there about what you have. I mean, today, when you sit here, does everybody know what assets they have. Do you have a listing of something that's going to be there? Do you have insurance? Does everybody have enough money in their bank account for to survive for a month, 2 months, 3 months? So it's like actually not just having it in your head, but actually having a listing and understanding what information you have personally today so that you can go into things tomorrow. And the same thing with reconciling. Budgeting is great, so that you can kind of say, here's what I want to do, here's how much money I have, here's the debt I have, here's what I want to spend it on. But then it goes into really having goals, because what are you going to budget for? So you need to, besides finances, it's what do you want to do with your life? What do I want to do in 5 years? Do I want to have a house? Do I want to have a new car? Do I want to go on a nice vacation? Do I have kids? Do I want to have some financial planning for their college? What do I want to do for retirement? So setting up those goals kind of then rolls back into budgeting. And then, of course, the fun one is spending. Because it's great to have a plan, but if you don't actually know what you're spending and you roll it back into your budget, it's all pretty much worthless. Really, it's a rolling process. And unfortunately, it's just like anything else in your life, there's a little bit of work involved. I kind of correlate it with my kids to doing laundry. You know, you're going to have clothes and you're going to wear clothes every day, your clothes are going to get dirty, and so what are you going to do? You know, you have to, either you throw them all over your room and you have to find them, pick them up, and put them into place, or you're going to set up a process so that you know, here's all my dirty laundry, and every Wednesday or every Saturday, I'm going to go and wash it. It's the same type of thing. It's part of your lifestyle and process. You have to make it part of, just like financial, the financial plan, just like your health side. If you don't set it up and put it into your lifestyle, then it becomes an issue. And so, really, it's setting up those things, and then really, you're planning for your future. So, and to do that, there's a, like I said, there's this one here, gigs. They have something in there about like a 4-week get ready, set, go. It's almost like the other side of the diet. It's like, here's the 4-week starter kit to get on your finance plans. And they set you up with a challenge so that you can go through and set like a really quick budget and a financing pieces. There's a whole bunch of different processes that you can do. And again, I think this website's really good. But guess what? You may also have something too. Humana actually has an associate website in the Associate Benefits Center. And I don't know if anybody's ever gone out to it, but it's a great place with a great resource.
My mouse,
hang on. Yeah, Roland's bringing it up on so everybody can see it.
There it is.
Perfect. So this is just a screen of the website. So when you get back to your desk, you can go on, go into your self-serve. And now he lost it. And in that website, they actually have a listing of different things, and one of them is finance. And so if you go into the financial planning, you'll actually see same thing. They have a one for debt. You know, how do you deal with debt? How do you plan for debt? They have another one for budgeting. There's another one for college education planning for your children. They have another one for retirement savings. And Schwab has some information there that you can actually go to. They have Schwab has a little thing for an app. It's called Mint.com. And that Mint.com, it's a little app, and you can put it on your phone, and it helps you track your savings, or your spending. So you can actually kind of go through and do it. And there's also, I know some of the banks, like my bank, actually has it where they have an app. You can kind of do the same thing right with your bank account. So you can actually see how much you're spending, what you're spending it on, and you can do it real time. So there's a whole lot of tools out there that you can use to actually help you in that process. Because sometimes we don't want to do it. It's hard, it's a pain, you have to think about it. But if you put it, like I said, into your lifestyle and process, it just becomes a matter of your daily routine. And so we finally got it up.
Yeah.
So if you look, there's a whole bunch of things, and if you scroll down.
See how we do this?
Yeah, I know. And there you'll see there's a whole bunch of different tools for processing. Like I said, the first one was managing your debt. The next one is budgeting, saving for your retirement. There's little tools that they have so that you can use on a site. Schwab actually has every couple months webinars. And I think you get like wow credits for even attending them. And then they do the same thing. They walk through financial planning. They have one for retirement. There's a whole bunch of resources out there that you can use. It's just a matter of picking one and doing it. Go back to the Excel spreadsheet. On your table, you'll see, and again, there wasn't a lot for everybody, but it's so small you really can't read it. And if you need to, what I can do is send the Excel spreadsheet out so that you have it, because you couldn't read it on this. It's too small. But this gives you a real good idea of what a budget should look like. And what I love about this spreadsheet is you'll see two columns. And it actually title forces you to say, you just don't do it once. You've got to go through and you have to figure out, okay, what expenses do I have? What revenue are coming in? And then guess what? You're going to modify it because it's not really what you thought. And I have that issue, so I'm sure everybody does, because you don't realize what you spend things on until you budget. And so a budget is not something you do once. It's always, always, always progressing. And it should actually go then to the next step of what you're spending. So again, it's a process, it's a lifestyle change. And that's why I kind of like that the Feed the Pig one, because they actually have a 4-week challenge. So give you like little steps to start your processes and down so that you can go to that next level instead of having to say, oh my gosh, I can't do this all at once. Well, you don't have to do it all at once. There's steps to it, there's processes, there's little things that you can do on a slow basis and then get to the level of something. Does anybody have any questions? Because I said a lot. And I know people on the phone, the screen, it's kind of hard to see, but it just gives you kind of an idea of what a budget is going to be, and then we'll send out the Excel spreadsheet. Also, the ABC site and Find Japan, they also have some tools with some Excel spreadsheets that you can use as well.
All right, next up, Roland.
Trying to get used to the headset all over again. My name is Roland DeGoto. I've been with you 10 years, but I've been in health insurance for something like 40 years. I was very blessed around 30 years ago. One of my first best bosses talked to all of us associates around 401ks, when 401ks were very new. And so today I'm trying to pay that forward, and I'm the champion for the security section to come in as Beller. And so that's another way I hope to try and pay that forward. Because the 401k, when you're starting out at an introductory salary and you're looking at those small dollars going in and you're thinking about everything else you could spend that money on, you don't really think about when you're going to be 65 or 67 and what you're going to need in 40 years of working. So I say this a lot, nobody else is going to worry about your retirement. It's all up to you to do this. We're very blessed because Humana gives us quite a bit of money extra if you're willing to do that. So just a show of hands for the folks in the room, how many of you have refused a raise this year? Anybody? So no hands, so I'm thinking that most of them are going to
be just me, Roland.
Yeah, I know. You're not an associate, it's okay. So think about this. if you're not at the 6% level of contributing to your 401k, you're giving away Humana's 7.5%. So Humana's giving, for that 6% you put in, Humana's giving you 7.5%. So total, 13.5%. So somebody on the phone's talking, I'd appreciate it if you put it on mute. Thank you. So how do you get started with this? For a lot of times what you hear when you start talking about this is, I can't afford it. There's just no way I can put 6% in. And I was there. I know exactly how you feel. But maybe you can get 2% in this year. And what worked great for me was every time I got a raise, I took some of that raise and increased it before I got it in my paycheck. So you plan it, you know, you go to the Schwab website, you say, I'm going to go from 2 to 3% this year. And before you know it, you're going to be at 10 years down the road, you'll be at, what, 12%, right? And then you're still getting the 7.5% from Humana. So something to think about. Now, if you don't have that discipline, the other thing you can do is go on the Schwab website and literally pick a date and say, every year on January, the first paycheck in January, I want my increase to go up for 1%. The disadvantage with that is, you may have gotten used to that salary increase and it's going to hurt a little more. But, you know, those are choices we have to make. Deb made a lot of great points about, you know, all of this is doing stuff today for a benefit for a long, you know, 30, 40 years from now. So you have to be able to say, yeah, I understand and I'm going to do this for much later. There's two different kinds of 401ks that Humana has. This is, every company offers these. There's the traditional 401k and then there's the Roth 401k. Basically, the difference here is whether or not you want to pay the tax at the beginning or at the end. If you're struggling to get 2, 3, 4, 5, 6% in, then I would suggest you go the traditional route. Because the reason for that is it's paid with pre-tax dollars. So Uncle Sam's letting you take 6% of your pay away, putting that money away for when you retire, and that's reducing your tax liability right now. And so if you're struggling to try and get money in, that's the best approach. If you're using a Roth or 401k, what happens is you're paying that with post-tax dollars. So you're paying the dollars today and then putting the money in your 401k. The advantage there is when you go to take it out in when you're 65, 67, you're not going to pay taxes on it then. So that's the advantage. Vesting. So Humana, if you've been here for less than 2 years, you won't be 100% vested. But it's remarkable that Humana vests in 2 years. So that goes by really quick. Again, 30 years ago when I started, it was a 5-year before. So it's a no-brainer, right? So you should be telling everybody, all your friends too. So one thing I forgot to mention is, for those of you that are in Dr. V's, Dr. Valverde's division, we know that only 44% of our associates are at the 6% level, based on the latest snapshot. Now, in other divisions, in DMS or, you know, in sales division, that may be different. But that means there are, you have a lot of people out there that you know and can influence that are not at the 6%. And maybe by talking about this, we can get people to think about going from 2% to 3%, finally getting to that 6%. Compounding. So if I were to ask you, I'm going really fast, but so I hope I'm getting my points across. If I were to ask you if you wanted, in 30 days, I could give you either $1 million or I could give you one penny compounded 100% every day for 30 days, which one of those would you choose? Most people would pick $1 million. So the beauty of compounding, right? Now, this is an extreme example. In this example, you can't hardly read it. I apologize. The color is too extreme. But on day one, you start with one penny. And this is going to double every day. So on day two, you go from one penny to two pennies. On day 30, you're at over $5 million. Now that's an extreme example, but it's showing you what the benefit of compounding is. So if you're 25, 35 years old today, you've got 30 years to work, right? And 30 or more years to work. So the magic of compounding is today for all of you. This is your opportunity now. The longer you wait, the more you're going to have to put money away. So, okay, get off that soapbox. The last thing I wanted to show you, I'm going to put my glasses on, is a website. So I apologize, it's going to take a minute. So, I chose this this website here just because it's easy for demonstration purposes. But our Schwab folks have a wonderful one on our site that we have. So if you go out that, it asks questions, and that one's really good. There's a lot of information out on that website, and it can be very daunting. Remember, there's always resources available. So if you call the customer service line at Schwab, they can hook you up with a financial planner so that you don't have to do this all alone, right? So you can call them. They'll actually do one-on-one meetings with you to help you set it up. Because it's not only putting the money in the 401k, it's where are you going to put those funds? Are you putting it in a target fund or whatever? So there's a lot of resources that Humana has put at our disposal, and I encourage you all to do this. I use this one here on this site. This is the Money Magazine site, just because it's really easy to use. So if I screen this around, it will make it easier for you. In this example here, here we have a 35-year-old, well, it's got a mind of its own. We have somebody 35 years old, planning on retiring at 67. Here's where they've already saved $100,000. That's huge, right? That 35, they've already been able to save $100,000. Their current salary is $55,000, and they're saving at 15%. So they're saving, in a Humana world, that means they're probably saving around 7% of their own money, and then 7.5% or so of Humana's money. This is just showing up, 1.7 is what we, you know, the estimate is what they need, and that person is already at $1.8 million. Pretty good. But if I go to this site, God forbid, but it's very touchy, so bear with me. If I take this 100,000 and now make that 10,000, $1.2 million. So that's why I was talking earlier about how important it is for you guys to do this now. Don't wait. The longer you wait, the harder it's going to be. And so sometimes you'll see people that are in their 50s or so, and they haven't done their pre-planning, right? And so now what are they doing? They're maxing out. They're like, they have to take every available penny that they have just so that they can get ready for retirement. And you can't live on Social Security. There's no way any one of us could possibly live on Social Security. You know, so you have to do this. It's so important for you and your family. So that's really all I had for today. I appreciate your attention, and go out there and start saving.
How does Value help with financial planning for the future? And is there any way to show us how to sign in on the website? I don't know if you have the time.
I can try. The website that Humana has, I won't specifically bring it up because the minute you bring it up, it brings up personal information.
You can keep the question on
the
website.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, it's okay.
So the question was the Value You website, and how does that link in with this? So Humana has this, hopefully you've all been out there. You get WOW dollars, I think, if you go out there once or twice a year. And it helps us look better to the corporate folks, so we like that. Basically what you do is you just go in, and I'll bring it up just so you can see where it is, and it will show you all of what Humana is putting in terms of your salary, what they're paying for your health insurance, what they're paying for taxes, Social Security, you name it, it's all there, and it's pretty amazing. So give me a second, I'll try and bring it up. So I'm under Humana self-service, and all you're going to do is just
write it
here.
Write it down.
It's so simple. And we'll send out a link when we send out the information from today. Anything else? All right, I'm going to turn it back over to, I got one question here.
401k, you said it was pre-tax. Is it possible to do a 50-50 combination?
Okay, the question was for the 401k, can you do both a 401k pre-tax and post-tax? And the answer is yes, you can do it in any combination you want. In fact, many financial planners will suggest you do that. it gives you more flexibility, so that if you don't want to spend that the post-tax money, you don't have to start spending 70.5. Whereas it's, if you're using pre-tax dollars, IRS will start forcing you to spend down some money at 70.5 for the year after.
To touch on that, I spoke to one of the Schwab advisors about that, and if you're worried about how it would impact your check, they can tell you.
Okay, so that question was, or comment was, if you're concerned how much that's going to impact your check, somebody, the Schwab customer service folks can help you figure that out. Great.
We're going to shift gears real quick. Now, this side of things, remember, it's all tying in today. Michelle brainstormed, and I told her the theme of our seminar today, and I told her to come up with something that she felt would just kind of plug into what we're discussing today on the financial side, the 401k side, and everything that Deb touched on. So Michelle Alonzo, our dietitian, is going to talk about the nutrition side of things as far as well-being and being able to do certain things with a little bit more money in your pocket. Okay? Michelle, come on up. Michelle Alonzo.
So I'm going to talk about nutrition on a budget, as all of us have, healthy living costs money too, healthy food, gym memberships, maybe personal training, whatever you value, but as far as nutrition goes, healthy eating does not need to be expensive. I think there's some exceptions of that, you go to places like Whole Foods and it takes up your whole check, but it doesn't have to be that way. So I'm just going to talk about a couple suggestions that you may or may not already do that make a big impact over, several weeks, several months, and whatnot. Okay, so quick grocery store tips that a lot of you may or may not do. Buying things in bulk. So I try to keep things in the fridge that are quickly prepared and healthy. So grains, like starchy carbohydrates, which fill you up quickly, I try to keep them in my fridge close. So I buy them in bulk to save money. I don't know if you guys ever made the trip down to Trader Joe's. That's open, it's a little south of here, but it's awesome and you really can buy things at a great price. So buying all of your grains is a good idea. Some places you can sell them on the wall, you can buy them by pound. It's better to buy them that way because you can store them as long as they're in a cool place and they're rancid. You'll have them for a long time. Frozen fruits and veggies are great. Fresh is awesome, but there's nothing wrong with frozen fruits and veggies. A lot of times it's picked at ripeness and then it's sent away right away. So it's better than canned, and a lot of times you'll get something that might even be fresher than buying fresh produce because they'll pick it before it's ripe. It'll ripen as it travels. So you might even get something better like that. I try to keep those stacked in my freezer all the time because, as you know, if you get caught with no food in your house, then you go out to eat and then you spend more money that way. So keeping groceries around is big. And I put inexpensive proteins. A lot of times in your house, eggs are cheap, canned tuna. I put sardines up here. I might be the only weirdo that likes to eat sardines. But they're high in omega-3s, and they're a great snack. And you buy a can for a dollar, and there's probably about 15 grams of protein, omega-3s. It's a healthy, quick snack if you're into that. Okay. And small things that I'm sure we're all aware of, but these are, and I'm guilty of it too, you spend so much money at Starbucks, or whether it be Dunkin' Donuts, buying coffee here, oh, do you want a coffee? I'll buy coffee for you. $4 or $5, go buy it quickly, that might happen more than once a day. So if you were to do that every day, it's about $1,800 for the whole year. And lunch out, so I said $12 a day because I feel like that might be on the low end, really. But if you're doing that on a daily basis, you're looking at over $4,000 a year. So, maybe once a week we all do this, but trying to cook in bulk, buy in bulk, bring it to work, and refrain from doing this not only is better for your health, but better for your pocketbook as well. And okay, so I gave some examples because sometimes we do get caught going somewhere and we're somewhere and you have to go run into a fast food place. And I mention this because the public really, even though we hear all these negative statistics, the public really is becoming becoming more aware of healthy eating and that we need to take care of ourselves, and there's an epidemic of obesity. So there is some positive statistics being shown, and these companies are paying attention. I don't know if you guys heard, but like McDonald's, I believe their like profits went down for the first time like ever. So a lot of these companies are offering like healthy initiatives. I know Wendy's has a whole like gluten-free food allergies thing they're promoting within their menu. So I just went to their websites and just pulled a couple items that I thought were good examples that you can still buy something cheap if you're in a rush and you don't have to eat something terrible, you know? Is this like the highest quality food? Okay, not really. But in life doesn't mean that if you get stuck going somewhere that you're going to ruin, you know, your diet. And you look at some of these items, they're under 400 calories, the highest grams of fat is 20, and decent amount of protein. So, you know, if you get stuck somewhere, I think all of these wraps are like under $2. So if you have to get stuck going somewhere, I very much believe that no matter where you are, you can find something good to eat.
Yeah, I think that was it. Yeah. Any questions or comments? Okay, all right, well, I'm enjoying that. You guys have no excuses now. You touched on everything under the sun. Real quick, and I'll be fast, and I want us to get back to work. When I tell people that your body is an investment, people kind of snicker. But like, I really try to take people's mentality and put them 25 years down the road. Just picture yourself where you're at now and tack on 25 to 30 years. Tell me how you feel, tell me how you look, and all the above. You know, at the end of the day, the healthier approach is gonna save you money, because long term, there's prescriptions, right? Preventable medications. People snicker sometimes and say, wow, you know, 40 or 50 bucks a month for training is crazy. But that's saving you a lifetime of those scripts every month, having to go to that pharmacy and pick up those pills. You know, I've had family members, when they passed away, they were taking over 35 pills a day at 87 years old. My grandfather took 5 a day, and one of them was omega-3, and the rest were all multivitamins. My grandfather worked out up until he was 87. He ran 2 miles a day up until he was 87. Other family members of mine, like I said, it was just a huge, huge pocket of pills. All right, so like I said, just fast forward in your life, just try to take a second and just tack on 25 to 30 years, maybe even 40 years of your life. I mean, who wants to live longer? Anyone? Anyone? Come on, let's be honest. Depends on the day, right? I mean, I don't want to live anymore. But, you know, when we get into preventative stuff, and preventative care is exercise, preventative care is eating healthier foods. There's so many studies now and cases that they're correlating, you know, processed and refined foods to cancer and this, that, and the other. I mean, every day I'm hearing something of one of my clients that I trained, one of their relatives, you know, just got cancer, stage 2, stage 3, stage 4. It's everywhere now. You know, and it's kind of hard not to correlate this stuff now with all the fast food out there. And I get it, what Michelle said, sometimes you have to go eat McDonald's. I did a few weeks ago. I was starving. I was coming back from another location, and I was like so hungry, I was nauseous. So I went and did it. But those are the few and far between moments where you have to go do it, which is fine. But if you're watching your lifestyle most of the time, you can handle those occasional eat quick meals. I'm sure, D'Angelo, when's the last time you had fast food? Be honest. Be honest, it's okay, we won't judge.
Last night.
All right, I will never ask you that question.
Grilled chicken from KFC.
Grilled chicken from KFC. And if you do it, we won't talk about that anymore. And here's the deal, there are fast food chains that are kind of quasi-healthy. I know Panera has the turkey chili. That's not too bad, right, Michelle? Okay. Will you look into it for me? Because Panera's right across the street, and I know there are those days.
And
Tina's on the road all the time, so.
But places like that, like, I think they're delicious, but you'd be surprised certain items that you might think that are toted as healthy, but so-and-so salad, might have more calories than having the small hamburger somewhere else. So it's nice, you know, all these places are on their websites. You can take a quick look on your phone before you go. You know, McDonald's hamburger has had less calories than all of those, like 280 MT. So, you know, yes, you can find something great everywhere, though.
Long story short, do you? Hello? Hello? We're doing a seminar, we'll call you back. It's okay, I trained her, we're cool, we're cool. Delgado! Do your research, folks. If you're going to eat fast food occasionally, if you know you have to, Tina's on the road a lot for large groups. She's always having to travel with clients. Do a little preparation, go online, search a little bit. Okay, if I have to go eat out, where is it going to be? My call is Panera. It's quick. You can order online or on your phone. You can pick it up. Bing, bang, boom. You're back to work. Okay, Chipotle is fantastic. Now you're going to get in my secrets. Chipotle is awesome. And I think it's like hormone free, right? It's all organic, Chipotle. Not the cheapest thing on earth, but remember, these once in a while, like D'Angelo last night, just so happened. All right, now to finish it all off, you guys may think I'm crazy because I'm hyper all the time, but I really am zen inside. So when I say zen mind, more or less enjoy your life more, every little thing, and all little components of our life, because we have so many components, from family to our health, and I can keep going and going and going and going. If we just make little changes in a positive aspect and just create less worry and more enjoyment in our lives, I'm going to go back to family members. There's some of my family members that just complicate their lives so much. And it's so easy as just kind of tweaking a little component here and tweaking another component here. And it's like night and day, the lifestyle that you could have from a positive aspect. It's little tweaks. And then, long story short, we've been talking for almost a year now, we just get bogged down. Because we see all the components and all the tweaks that we gotta make, the small tweaks, and the tweaks add up. So, you know, starting today, saving a little bit more, everything that we put out there, from Roland to Deb to Michelle, put it all together. We're really trying to do a better job at our resources and tapping you guys into the right resources. Michael, Syme, Michelle, Deb, Roland, we're all here. We all have emails. If you guys have questions, come to us. Michael, Syme, can you stand up for a second? One of our medical director guys, he's on our wellness team. He actually runs the health side. Michael is doing an incredible job at running the health side of this committee. I've learned so much from them in a short amount of time. I wish he was here 10 years ago, even though I wasn't here 10 years ago. We're have the food trucks coming in within the next 4 to 6 weeks. We're going to bring more food trucks this time. I think we have 6 of them. Right? Is it 6 trucks? What? We're right around 5 to 6 trucks. So that's right around the corner. We're going to announce our next seminar for next month, which is March 5th or March 6th. March 6th, okay. So we have a lot of good things coming. We're going to announce the boot camp. The one thing that Michael started working on, I believe with JD, was having one website or one page where everything is on the site. So from Vitality tools to anything else we can think about, financial tools, find these links. The YouTube page, the Facebook page, that's for me to put all the community stuff out there. And I got to tell you, it's fantastic taking all these photos and walking around the hallways and putting that stuff on there, because we have a lot of amazing people here in Humana Miramar. And just to see all the groups of people when I take the photos and put everyone together, it's really nice. So we create a nice community page, picture-wise, and videos, and you know, everything we did today, we're gonna put on the YouTube channel and the Facebook page. So if you guys wanna go back and watch the whole thing over, because they did such a good job. If it's something that you missed in the seminar, go watch it on the YouTube channel. All right, guys, feel free to email us. Okay, we're not scared. We're vulnerable to meeting time. All right? Now, I want to thank everyone, but I have to read this code because I always get yelled at. For everyone on the phone, the code is 85436. 85436. I want to thank everyone on the phone and everyone in this room today. You guys are awesome. Thank you.
when the moon December heading for the city lights and 975 we sharing each other and mirror the father son of the lemon drips from your eyes. We are the people that rule the world. A force running in every boy and girl. All rejoicing in the world. Take me now. We can try. We live the adventure. Love the summer.
All right, y'all, you better have three, 1, 2, 3.